Dear students, in today's session we are going to discuss one of the models of price leadership, which is a special case of collusive oligopoly. Price leadership model basically can be for multiple reasons, but in many market structures, the firm which has the lowest cost structure tends to lead the industry. Now, in this particular case, we are assuming that there are two firms which produce a homogeneous product at different cost, which clearly can be sold and must be sold at the same price. The price is chosen by the low-cost price leader. Firms may have equal markets or may not have equal markets, and accordingly they may end up producing same or different level of output. However, an important condition of this model to be kept in mind is that both the firms have an equal cost structure. Now, in order to further understand this, you can see in the diagram that the first case is pertaining to the situation where the firms are assumed to be sharing the market equally. So you have a common market demand curve for both the firms, and you have an individual demand curve, and against that you have marginal revenue curve, wherein we are saying that MR1 is equal to MR2. 1 and 2 basically implies for two firms. On the x and y axis of both the diagrams, we have taken output and price cost revenue respectively. And in the second diagram, we are going to discuss the case where both the firms are facing different demand curves, DA and DB, and against them they also have their own marginal revenue curves, MRA and MRB respectively. Let us start completing and drawing the diagrams, and I would recommend that all of you sit with a paper and pencil in order to start understanding how to go and take the next steps. So we are now going to draw the average cost curve for first firm in the diagram which is towards the left. We can draw another average cost curve for the second firm simultaneously. Now, against this, we can draw a marginal cost curve which intersects the average cost curves at their lowest point. We can name these curves now. We can call the marginal cost curve of the first firm as MCA. Similarly, average cost curve of the second firm as ACB. Marginal cost curve of the second firm as MCB. Now, in order to understand the price and equilibrium output, we need to note the point where MR is, where MC is intersecting MR, and draw a line upwards till the demand curve, and also drop it perpendicular downwards to the x-axis. Let's do that. So wherever this red line, which has started from the point of intersection, intersects the demand curve, that will give us the price line. Like this. Now we can check what would have been the price of the second firm by using a different color. So MR and MC are intersecting at this point, so we can draw a perpendicular downwards. And also extend it till the demand curve in order to get the price line. So let me name all of these. So PA is the price which will be charged by first firm, firm A, because it has come from the intersection of MR1 and MCA, and PB is the price that can be charged by the second firm as it has come from the intersection of MCB and MR2. However, that may not continue because if the dominant firm is a low cost price leader, very well he would be concentrating the market with its lowest prices, and if the second firm will not follow the first firm, that is firm A, then there are chances that he will lose the entire market to firm A. In that case, clearly you can say that the common price that will be decided to be charged as both the firms enter into collusion would be PA. So let me show that to you, that how this works for the whole market. What you have to do, you have to extend this price line till the market demand curve, and from there you have to drop a perpendicular down as well in order to get the total output to be produced by both the firms. Let us name these, give them a name. So the total output can be considered as X1 plus X2 which shows the output produced by both the firms, and how much each firm would produce individually, that we can note as X1 is equal to X2. So this red colored line which is dropping down, that is showing the output which will be produced by both the firms individually, and both of them are equal levels of output because this is the case of equal market share. So this situation has been accepted by the second firm, which is firm B, because this firm does not want to take the risk of getting engaged into a price war and seemingly losing the market, as he's already having a high cost structure. So it's better for the second firm to follow the market leader and produce same level of output and charge the same price, PA. Now let us see that how this situation may slightly differ when you have two firms with unequal market shares, and that is why you have two demand curves and two marginal revenue curves. Let us try to draw average cost curve in the second diagram. Initially we will be drawing for the firm A and then we will draw for firm B. So we will intersect, we'll call this as ACA, which is average cost curve, and let us also draw the MR curve for this firm, which is intersecting from its lowest point. Incidentally, in my diagram, it is intersecting at MRA, but in your case, that may differ, and that's completely all right. So I am now dropping a perpendicular downwards to check the price and output being produced. as per the point of intersection. So wherever MR is intersecting MCA, we will be dropping a perpendicular downwards to get the equilibrium quantity of output to be produced. And in order to check the price, we will extend it to DA and also get to know the price line. So let me name each one of them for clarity. So this PA is the price to be charged by firm A, which is also the dominant price leader, because this firm has low cost curve, lower cost curve which is low relatively to the second firm, which we are just going to draw now in a while. We can name it as XA. And let's now move to the diagram for the second firm. For that, let me select a different color so that it's clear to you. So along with me, you can draw another cost curve anywhere. This red color cost curve we are drawing for the second firm. And let us draw another MC curve which is intersecting this at its lowest point. And please note the point of intersection. The point of intersection of MCB with MRB is this, and from there we are dropping a perpendicular down to the x-axis, and we are extending it upwards till DB. Okay, because that's the demand curve for firm B, and from there we are extending it to y-axis in order to get the price that would be preferably charged by the second firm. Let me name all of them. So as I mentioned, this is A, this is MC B, and here we can have AC B. In my case, this is not working, but you can write here ACB. Okay, now it has come. So this is price PB. Let me try again. If it works, I would like to write here ACP. Okay, it has come here. Let me write here ACB, which is the average cost curve for the second firm. So now let me explain to you that how the market is going to be divided, because this is a case of unequal market share. So the first firm, as you can see, has decided to produce XA quantity of output and sell it at PA price. Now this first firm is also the low cost firm, because its average cost curve is lying below the ACB, which is the average cost curve of the second firm. So clearly is the low cost price leader, and the second firm, which is having a higher cost structure, will follow the first firm. Now in following the first firm, the second firm will have to charge the same price, that is PA, and the output produced by the second firm can be clearly understood through the yellow line which I am going to draw now. So the output produced by the second firm is wherever this price line is intersecting DB, from there you need to extend a perpendicular downwards. Okay, and we can write here, we can write here XB XBE, anything you can write to show that this would be the actual quantity of output to be produced by the second firm. Okay, so let me give you a quick recap. In this price leadership model, the factor which has been stressed is that the leader sets the price and the follower adopts it. And it is clear that formally or informally, both the firms may decide how to share the market, whether to share it equally or unequally. And after deciding that, the price follower is going to start producing output as per the division set by the price leader. Although it may be more profitable for the second firm in both the cases to produce a lower output and charge a higher price, but despite this profitability situation, they will not choose that, and rather than not take a risk, not compete, and will choose to enter into collusion with the low cost price leader, and in the first diagram produce equal output, and in the second diagram produce unequal level of output. So that is how the low cost price leader in general can lead the entire industry, because the cost conditions differ in reality also, and low cost firms generally give tough competition to the existing firms. I hope you could understand how to draw the diagram through this video. I'll get back to you soon. Thank you.